not feeling any less sour. I promise myself to treat myself and visit a nearby tower. I'm climbing to the top, throw myself off in an effort to make it clear to whoever what it's like when you're shattered, left standing in the lurch at a church where people sing your mind's tough. She stood him up, no point in us remaining. We may as well go home, as I did on my own, alone again, naturally. To think that only yesterday I was cheerful, bright and gay, looking forward to what wouldn't do the role I was about to play. But as if to knock me down, reality came around, and without so much of a mere touch, cut me into little pieces, leaving me to doubt. Talk about God and His mercy, if He really does exist, why did He deserve my hour of need, truly and indeed, alone again, naturally. It seems to me that there are more hearts broken in this world that can't be mended, left unattended. What do we do? What do we do? Over the years, and whatever else that appears, I remember I cried when my father died, never wishing to hide the tears. At 65 years old, my mother, God rest her soul, couldn't understand why the only man she had ever loved had been taken, leaving her to start with a heart so badly broken. Despite encouragement from me, no words were ever spoken. And when she passed away, I cried and cried all day, alone again, naturally, alone again, naturally.